Thank you. get on stage. You guys have seen those progressive commercials about how you're not supposed to end up like your parents, and they have that guy that's trying to help them along.
Oh, I love that.
And the guy sits down, he's like, ah. So when I get on stage, it's always, ugh. So it's kind of unavoidable.
Yes.
That's just a little taste. Alright, we're going to do a quick recheck here. Before we do our next number, I'd like to talk a little bit about it. This is one of Duke Ellington's, one of the thousands of compositions that he has created, and he's just kind of one of our greatest national treasures in terms of what he did for jazz in general, the live jazz scene. He had his own big band that toured everywhere. He had some of the greatest players tour with him, and they went on to do great things after playing with him. And his music has so much character and personality, and I think that's why I love it so much, because he wrote for the people in his band, and they all had different personalities. This particular tune he wrote for Johnny Hodges, who played lead alto for Duke Ellington for many years, decades, and he had a very distinct style. And this is from the Shakespearean Suite, and it's going to feature Kendall on alto sax. She's going to be playing the role of Johnny Hodges, and you'll hear a little bit of commentary along the way. And again, with the personalities in his band, he had a Barry sax player, his name was Harry Carney, and Harry was known for just kind of having these little almost outbursts that would be somewhat to the left of what the style of the piece was, but somehow he made it fit. So Thomas is going to play that role tonight. We hope you enjoy Star-Crossed Lovers. This isn't necessarily, they're not star-crossed lovers, they just happen to be playing the part, just in case anybody was thinking I picked that because of, you know, romantic reasons. Peter just said literally no one was thinking that until you said that. Keep me grounded. It's that was one of the reasons that she has received Outstanding Soloist, Outstanding Performer Awards at some of the different festivals that we've been to, and it's also one of the reasons that she was named first alternate for the state of Iowa Class 4A All-State Jazz Band. So how about a round of applause? All right, this is one of my favorite tunes, and I have a lot of like favorites, obviously, but this is such a different feeling kind of tune, written by Fred Sturm, who unfortunately is no longer with us, but he's just like this kindest, warm soul that I've ever met, and he's really put some great compositions out into the world. And this, you'll hear a lot of different sounds. We've got the vibes here. Alexa's gonna be playing those for you. We'll have a little bit of guitar mingling. We have some triangle going on. We have Connor on piano. We have the soprano sax being played by Kendall this time. And there's just a lot of really cool things happening. So I really hope you enjoy Riverscape by Fred Sturm. Thank you. for something completely different. We're going to wrap up our set for the evening with a Latin tune, kind of a cha-cha that you're going to hear different solos and people in the band. I got to make sure I get it right here. We've got Peter on trombone playing the first solo. All right, and then we have Thomas playing solo on Barry Sax, and you'll hear why he was one of the outstanding soloist award winners at our SIBA Jazz Festival, and I was sitting on this tune, so about a hand for Thomas on Barry saxophone. You will hear a solo from Lex on guitar, and you will hear why he was also the recipient of Outstanding Performer Awards at a lot of the festivals that we went to this year. And he was named recently the guitarist chosen for the State of Iowa All-State Jazz Band in Class 4A. So Lex. Excited about that. They take one guitar from the state, and Kendall was one of three alto saxophones in the entire state. So they are really, I'm really proud of everybody, and these guys have been working really hard, so it's been a pleasure. Our last tune for our set is going to be kind of a funky title tune. It's entitled Uchibang Wow Wow. Everybody say that.
Uchibang Wow Wow.
Yeah, see, I want to see, because some of you were like, wow, wow. That's just naturally how it comes out sometimes. Thank you.
Thank you.